the Madison Supercharger, Easttown Mall one. And when I got here, two of the stalls were in use and one of them weren't. I had actually 0 miles left, even running heat conservative. I was pushing about 550 watt hours per mile because it is 0 degrees. The problem became that stall that nobody was using. The reason they weren't using it was because there was slush, frozen slush, packed inside the charge handle. So it would not fit into the charge port of the car. Tried and tried and tried. Well, I did not have an option to go to the other supercharger. Thankfully, there is one about a mile and a half from here, but I was literally below zero on the range by the time I got here. And the Model 3 that was here had about a 50% charge, and they flat out said, we're not moving until we have our 100% charge. I mean, common courtesy, they could have at least, you know, let me charge for 2 minutes so I could go to the other location. And they were just sitting in their car eating, so why they wouldn't choose the other location anyways, who knows. And there's a Model X with nobody. Family was already inside the mall, so we had to fix it myself. And here we are. Cleaned out the charging on this supercharger, the charge handle. Still got a little bit charging up there. And there. Now, at least on the US style charging. Okay, so now what the problem was is there was slush and snow, and I'm going to use my J1772 adapter because this is the same plug end as the supercharger for the US or North America. There we go. Now, there was slush packed in here because someone left the cord dangling instead of hanging it back up. So both of those had slush. There's a tiny bit in these. In general, the two pins on the side, these are 12 volt and enable communication between the supercharger and the car. And there's 12 volt going through here, DC. This is the ground down here. Now the two 12 volt pins generally will not have anything in them. The hole's just too small. So whatever's in there usually whatever gets in there usually is not enough to affect things. There might be some in here. And first, what you can use, if you don't have anything, you can use a key, a small key, and gently go around. I happen to always carry a toolbox, and I think I'm going to put together a good emergency supercharging kit, what to do if there's something stuck in the plug. And sometimes you just need to supercharge. You really need to supercharge. So I went around. I cleaned out gently, and you don't have to scrape at it usually, but just gently go around both of these to loosen up what's in there. Then you take it and you just tap it real good, or take your shoe off and hit the end of it with your shoe gently to knock it out. But where the real problem was actually down inside here, because the car also has a plastic fitting that goes right in this slot. Well, there was about a centimeter or maybe a half inch excuse me, of frozen slush and ice in here. So then I used my handy dandy precision screwdriver and went in there, loosened it up, tap, 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 loosen up, tap, tap, tap. Now it's 0 degrees. It was still not the easiest. Like, I had to go warm back up every couple of minutes of working on it. It took about 10 minutes to actually get it loosened up, because you got to go gently. You don't want to break the charge cable. Otherwise, you are completely screwed. So by doing that, I was able to get enough out where the supercharger plug would fit into the vehicle and actually start charging, because a supercharger will not charge if you get red or even the yellow. Now, your regular AC powered connectors, or even J1772, your car will charge up to 16 amp at 120 or 240 volts if you get an orange slash yellow charge status ring on your charge port or light on your charge port. It will not charge full power, but on supercharger, for safety reasons, it will not charge at all. But once I got enough of it in where it activated, the heat buildup from actually charging managed to melt everything else out of the charge port. So that comes down to Shut that off. That gives us a working charge port. And in the case of the Model 3 owner, I got like an 80% charge, and they were still sitting at the supercharger as I walked out of JCPenney and drove off only as I approached. Talk about rude, but I guess that's what some of it's come down to. It doesn't matter what kind of car it is, you're always going to get rude drivers. So I am going to put together another video with a little bit of a supercharging kit of emergency tools that could save your butt, and not just for superchargers. This might happen with a J1772 plug, or say you're relying on a high-powered Tesla wall charger somewhere out in the middle of nowhere, and I've relied on those too. And if something's stuck in that, you might be stuck somewhere or calling a tow truck. So you never know. Now, obviously, if you can avoid it, if you're at a location with multiple stalls available and not, you know, it's not completely packed, then obviously just switch stalls and, you know, wait for a thaw for that stall to, you know, empty out. But if you are at a location like the Easttown Mall Madison here, now just recently, it's been actually about a year now, they opened up a second location, but for, 4 years, we only had 3 supercharging stalls here, and there was always a nice queue of cars waiting to charge here. So, you know, some locations you can get stuck, and I've seen other ones. You know, what if there was also, there's been a lot of supercharger vandalism lately by gas car drivers, gas holes, and what if they had taken all the charge cables and jam-packed them with snow and slush? You would have been screwed if every single one. So hopefully this was some good tips. You might have learned a little something. And stay tuned for my emergency supercharge cleanout kit video coming up.